Hello, I'm Stumpy the Squirrel. Let's make a game with RPG in a box. In this tutorial, we'll create a door that opens and closes. Let's get started. Start up RPG in a box and open your How to Make a Game project. Using the modeling and animation knowledge you learned from the first three episodes, create some sort of door or gate with an open and close animation. Since we need to interact with it, the model should be created as an object and not a tile. Name the animations open and close, and use the clamp type for both so they will stop at their last frame. Open the forest village map and place the door in the opening of the wall. Connect interact-only lines between the door and the tile on each side. We'll need a way to keep track of the current state of the door, so we know whether it's currently open or closed. Select the door and go to the Entity Properties tab. The Custom Properties section provides a way of storing values that are unique to a specific entity. Create a Boolean property and name it Closed. A Boolean is like an on-off switch and can have a value of either true or false. Since the door begins in a closed state, click the false value to change it to true. So far, the door will not yet function and only prevent the player from walking through, which is not a very useful door. Before creating the script, however, let's make a sound effect to liven up the door a bit. Open the Sound FX Generator, generate a suitable door sound, then save it. Now create a new script and call it Door. Remove the display message node, then add a play sound node from the list of functions by dragging and dropping it beside the start node. Choose the door sound effect, if it's not already selected. Next, we need to determine if the door is currently open or closed by checking the property we created for the door entity in the map editor. Add Evaluate Condition node and change the expression to check if the closed property of self is true, either by typing it in or using the wizard at the bottom. The self keyword will refer to the entity to which the script is attached. In this case, the door. We need to trigger three events for the door: playing an animation, modifying navigation paths, and updating the closed property. Add a play animation node to play the open animation. Ensure that it gets connected to the first output of the condition node. The first output is the path the script will take if the condition being checked is true. In this case, if the door is closed. Add a replace navigation node to change any surrounding navigation paths from interact only to walk and interact. This will allow the player to walk through when the door is open. Add a set entity property node to change the closed property to false to keep track of its new state. Duplicate those three nodes and connect them to the else output of the condition node. The else output is the path the script will take if the condition being checked is false, that is, when the door is open. Update the nodes as necessary to handle the reverse logic for when the door is open and should close. Specifically, play the close animation, revert the navigation paths back from walk and interact to interact only, and set the door entity's closed property back to true. Save the script now that we're done. Go back to the map editor, select the door from edit mode, and assign the door script to the character interacts trigger event. Save the map, then use quick play to test out our door. There is one minor issue with this type of door. The door can be closed whilst standing under it. We will revisit this in the future, but for extra credit, add another condition at the beginning of the script to check the player's coordinate and prevent it from closing. Or even better, check the built-in character's property of the tile under the door to ensure that no characters are present. The solution to this can be found in the project files linked in the description. Congratulations, you've created a working functional door. Thank you so much for watching, my dear friend. You are a lovely and wonderful person. Until we meet again.